What's up guys, this is Jim Bones, this is my second video. Today I want to tell you how to make gold while leveling and in a very easy way. So here I'm on the private server just to show you the first tip. It's with enchanting. So basically in my first video, 5 tips how to level faster in WoW Classic, I told you guys to make some alternate characters. Well, what you could do with this alternate character is to reach level 5 and then you can learn enchanting, and in Classic you don't need to be level 300 enchanting to disenchant level 60 items, by example. So only with level 1 enchanting you can disenchant all the items that you want. So here, as you can see, I'm only 1 enchanting. I can disenchant the Wild Heart Call, which is level 57, excuse me. So what I want to tell you is make an alternate character, grind it level 5, get the Orgrimmar, learn the enchant, and then you can just send all your greens to this character in order to disenchant it and sell the materials on the auction house. This tip is of course more worthy as you get higher level, because the materials will be more useful for higher people approaching the raids. So I'm doing this video one take, by the way, so I want to make this quick. Second tip will be all of the blue BOEs. So I found a guide on WoWhead, it's called Best Worst BOE Drops Classic WoW. So here you can see all the good, the bad, and the average blues that you can find in the instances, and that will work a lot on the auction house. So by example, Shadowfang Keep, you have the Shadowfang, the Assassin's Blade, which are very good for twinks, and that you can sell for a lot of gold on the auction house, excuse me. So the best tip I could give you is wait until selling these. You should not sell them, as there are a lot of people in these leveling zone. In 2 or 3 months, when these items will be much rare, you will be able to sell them on the auction house, and it's gonna work a lot more gold. Other than that, I wanted to tell you that you should keep all the resist gear. As you will see in this guide, the resist, even though in BFA it was not that much of a deal, it's a big deal in WoW Classic. So you should keep all your greens, like 40 plus, that gives fire resistance, because you know molten core is a lot of fire damage, and maybe eventually for AQ, but it's not right now, nature or some other resistance gear that might be useful in the future. The third item should be the fire resistant potion. As I told you, a lot of guilds there, especially if you're in the high pop server with a lot of streamers, a lot of the big guild, they will need the materials because they want to clear molten core in the first or second week. They will need the materials in order to craft these greater fire protection potion. As you can see, it absorbs like 2 to 3k fire damage, which is very good clear molten core very early in the process. And in order to grab these, you need the elemental fire, and I click there, and the elemental fire they drop from multiple sources. By example, the fire elemental in Ungoro Crabber. So my point here is, if you want to grind some level, because you know in Classic you can't always do the quest, there are not enough quests in the zone in order to complete all the levels. So if you want to go in Ungoro Crabber there, grind half a level farming these fire elementals, get the heart of fire, get the elemental fire in order for the guild to craft them. So it's gonna work a lot on the auction house, guys, I tell you. Number 4 is a very good tip, of course, it's pretty obvious, but the Black Lotus. So if you're herbalism, there is a rare herb, you can compare it to the anchor weed in BFA. So it's only found in some zones, Winter Spring, Eastern Playland, Burning Steps, Silithus and Blasted Lands, and they are an ingredient in order to craft the flasks. So the flasks are gonna be a very important piece in Classic. As you can see here, in what I see and what I'm telling, is all the consumables in Classic are very important. You should spend 2 hours farming a flask. It will be more worth than if you farm 10 times all BRS for an upgrade. Like, consumables are a big deal in Classic. So Black Lotus, if you can get ahead of the curve in the leveling process, farm a lot of Black Lotus, you will make a ton of gold, because these guilds, they want the world first, in the molten core, they want all of that stuff, and maybe you don't really care, you only play 5 hours a week, maybe not at the launch, but if you can get ahead of the curve, farm these Black Lotus before everyone, you'll make a shit ton of gold, guys, I tell you. Number 5, this one is less obvious, but it's the Wicked Claw, so if you kill all the Panthers in Stragglethorn Vale, as you can see there, you should keep these Wicked Claws. The reason is pretty simple. The Lionheart Helm here is the best in slot for warriors, and you see there are 40 Wicked Claws required. I don't know about the Wealth Shed, but anyway, this one was just a very quick tip whenever requesting the Stragglethorn Vale. Other than that, there is the Spider Silk. So as soon as you find a Spider Silk, you should go on Wildhead and look what is this reagent for. As you can see here, it's useful for a lot of fire resist gear. So the Iron Web Spider Silk are gonna sell for a shit ton. As I tell you, the fire resist, all that stuff, it's very, very useful in Classic. So again, you should keep these Iron Web Silk and sell them on the auction house. Okay guys, this is it for this video. Super, super fast videos. Thank you. You should, if you liked the video, if you enjoyed it, you should like it. Comment, give me some tips for my next videos. Subscribe and share it with your friends. Thank you. This is Jambone. See you in Classic. And I hope you had a great time. Thank you. See you guys.